Hello everyone and welcome to this video. So today I got the best idea ever. The most stupid, I mean the bestest idea came to mind when I decided that, hey, I wanted to make myself go through a little bit of a challenge. Just that this challenge will probably end up ruining my soul and heart. So I've already done like a million sketches, and as you see here, I'm just gonna kind of do this. This was first sketch. It looks horrible. This is the second sketch, just that I think it's... Yeah, this was second sketch. It's definitely better than the first ones. I mean, it looks a little bit better. And then this, which also... This was my third sketch, and it looks worse. It looks a whole lot worse. It went from this to this. That's not a good sign, you know. And since I hate drawing wings, which is a sincere problem I do have, it went from this to me doing this, because I needed to redraw those wings. And then I decided that it would be a great idea, like the greatest idea, to try and replicate this thing. And then I decided on this one, because it looks better than this mess over here. At least a little better. And then we have this mess, which basically is more sketches, which I'm doing for... Wait, I haven't even explained the challenge. Well, basically, the challenge is that I'm gonna try to mix a lot of animal features and make a species out of it. Now, I have zero idea how I'm supposed to do this. This is why I'm putting up so many sketches, because, yeah.
One of the animals I will be using as a reference is, I'm going to use tree kangaroos, which is a pretty rare species. They are endangered, and I really love tree kangaroos. I don't know why specifically I love them so much. I love tree kangaroos. They are so cute, and beautiful, and gorgeous, and everything that could have been. They are basically the cutest animals on earth. That's the only thing I can say. And then I decided it would be a good idea to include otters to the list. Now, don't look at me like that. Cinder, are you trying to make a cute species? Is that all this is about? Is this all this is about? Well, kind of, and no. It's a little bit of both. Honestly, it's a little bit of both. Because I honestly really, 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 really love owl animals. And there would have been no other way for me to live. I love all animals pretty much equally. But I'm including some other creatures also. I'm also going to put in some other animals, which is a little bit more fierce, I could say. Like, this is just a little bit for riff, because I'm just trying to figure things out. I wanted to add sparrow wings to this, because I love sparrows. Sparrows are so cute, I love them. I of course have to do hair tufts, because all animals have them. And I want to go with otter ears, and I also wanted to add a bit of a narwhal aspect to it. So I want to make this an original species by altering... Okay, if you all didn't know from before, many species in real life is actually very similar to each other. And, you know, that's just how this world kind of works. There's literally no other way this world could have worked. So, you're saying, okay, so Cinder, you're making a hybrid. Well, kind of, just that I'm going to use everything, every aspect of this, to make an original species. every single aspect of this mess. I decided to also add a whole lot of other animals. You don't understand how many animals I'm adding to this. I'm even including very fussy bears, because I, you know what, I can't. And I'm probably going to put in some Ethiopian wolves, because I have a weird thing for endangered animals, supposedly. I don't know. Now, Cinder, why are you making bears a part of this? Yo, it's the part of the challenge, I suppose. I'm supposed to make an animal out of, like, the most random species out there. So, I mean, I'm supposed to make a horribly random animal. I don't know what I'm even doing with my life at this point. I'm horrible at drawing bears, honestly. I also wanted to add another feature from bears, but a specific type of bears. I can't remember the name of the bear species I want to use, but it's actually an English species of bear. Let me see here. I'm just gonna turn my sound off because I have to search up that animal that I need to, like, kind of just find? Let's see here. Kermode bear. I want to put some Kermode bear into it as well. Because I thought, when I first heard of the species, I was like, oh my god, those are cute. I'm not going to use the white part of it as an aspect. They look kind of like ice bears. They are very fussy. And I'm going for a very fussy style, okay? I will have to make another one of these, because I need to, like, have some space to make fur. But anyway, now that you all understand the challenge, I'm gonna be back when I've gotten my rest done. Oh, this is gonna be silliest. This is the silliest idea I've ever had, honestly.
Okay, so I'm back, finally. This took some time, because, it was kind of hard to mimic everything into the final design I wanted. It was kind of a little bit harder than expected. Like, I expected it to be hard, but not this hard, especially since I'm experimenting with animals I've never experimented with before, so of course it's gonna be hard. I just noticed the detail I want to add. There we go. I like that. I want to add that detail. And I think actually a little floof hair would actually look pretty decent. Now this is the sketches for tails, ears, floofs, everything you'd ever look for in this animal creature thing. I'm still working on the floofs though. So, this should basically be a basic reps of the floofs I decided to use, and this is a basic, basic ref of what type of things I wanted to use. So, this was not particularly easy, if that makes any sense, this is the wings I'm deciding to use. So this is gonna be really interesting, honestly. I'm gonna delete that. I'm keeping that, actually. I'm deleting that. I'm deleting that, and I'm deleting that. No need to have that. Now this is a lot less messy, at least. Now we got the main refs done. Now we just have to see how this is gonna look all together. And yeah. Now I'll put up some music and you can all watch my sketching progress. I'm just kidding. I'm just gonna talk through this whole thing, but this is the done with the live talking thing. well, see y'all later. Bye bye. Well, bye bye to the live.
right here, right now, I put the offer out. I don't wanna chase you down. I know you see it. You run with me, and I can cut you free out of the treachery of walls you keep in. So trade that typical for something colorful. And if it's crazy, live a little crazy. You can play it sensible, a king of conventional, or you can risk it all and see. I'm good to go, cause I quite enjoy the life you say I'm trapped in. Now I admire you, and that'll show you do. You're onto something, really it's something. But I live among the swells, and we don't pick up peanut shells. I'll have to leave that up to you. If I were mixed up with you, I'd be the talk of the town. Disgraced and disowned, another one of the clowns. But you would finally live a little, finally laugh a little. Just let me give you the freedom to dream, and it'll wake you up and cure your aching. Take your walls and start them breaking. Now that's a deal that seems worth taking. But I guess I'll leave that up to you. It's intriguing, but to go would cost me greatly. So what percentage of the show would I be taking? Well, fair enough, you'd want a piece of all the action. I'd give you 7, we could shake and make it happen. I wasn't born this morning, 18 would be just fine. Why not just go ahead and ask for nickels on the dime? 15, I'd do 8, 12, maybe 9.
Hello everyone, and I'm back. I've got a sketch done now, so that's sweet, nice. I actually really like how this is coming along. I didn't actually think I were gonna like this as much as I actually did. This is actually turning out pretty great, and it seems original. I don't think I've seen anything like this before. I'm just gonna take down the layers in opacity. I probably need a little bit more of an opacity. Problem for future Cinder. Let's just take it up a little bit more in opacity. There we go. And live Cinder will be back. I don't know when.
Well, I didn't tell anyone, but a bird flew by. So what I'd done, he set up a nest outside. And he sang about what I'd become. He sang so low, sang so clean. I was afraid all the neighbors would hear. So I invited him in just to reason with him. I promised I wouldn't do it again.
everyone, and we are back. Now I've got the line art done, and what am I gonna say? I love this. I love this so damn much. I didn't even think this would turn out this great. Oh my god, I'm so in love with this little fella. I haven't even decided on, I have literal no idea. I had no idea this would be the outcome when I first decided to do this challenge. I mean, I could have done better. I don't think there's anything I could have done to make this even better. I love this little fella. He's so cute. That wasn't quite the point, but this is what I made, and this is what it is, I guess. I can't help it. Well, the next phase is gonna be the coloring phase, so, see y'all later. I want to color this guy in, because I love him so much.
Running around, throwing that dirt all on my name. Cause you knew that I'd call you up. You've been going around every party in LA. Cause you knew that I'd be at one. Oh. I know that dress is karma, perfume regret. You got me thinking about when you were mine. Oh. And now I'm all upon you, what you expect. But you're not coming.
Yeah. pushing myself aside. Why can I get it right? I don't know. You're always watching me fall. Shadows, they like my wall. Why do I feel so small? I don't know. So I walk into the dead of night, where my monsters like to hide. Chaos feels so good inside, now I know.
Jungle birds is a species of something unknown, although their name is jungle birds, or in the more correct version, they are Avis saltus. Their scientific name is Latin for jungle birds, although they definitely are not birds in any shape or form. Their name comes from them living up in the treetops in the jungle, jumping from tree to tree, almost like they're flying using their unusable wings for balance. The wings are like a part of their body, as the wings are connected to the shoulder blades of a saltus. They come in many color variations, such as white, brown, gray, black, but they only come in light colors, with an exception for black. They usually have darker and lighter colors on their palette. More exactly, they have pastel colors. More exactly, they can have dark and light colors as long as they're pastel. More exactly, black and gray are probably the two most common palettes for them, but brown and white isn't too limited either way. They also might come with albinism. But if they do, the chance of salt being blind is about 70%, and when they don't suffer from albinism, they have a 20% rate of being blind. They also have a 20% chance of being deaf, also affected by albinism.
That means that if a software have albinism, it will also be 70% rate chance of being deaf. Their diet range from fruits, vegetables, although they also really enjoy fish, oddly enough. They are peaceful and quiet, but they are true happy-go-lucky species, and one of their favorite things to do is to jump from around trees and compete with each other. They are social, but also alert, even though they aren't seen as a good snack for many animals, because saltos are partly carnivore, and there is few carnivores that eat carnivores. Their biggest problem is humans, although no humans have ever gotten a glimpse of them, and if they were to get a glimpse of them, they would mess it up and think it's a tree kangaroo. Which seems to be the case, as they do have a similar tail and lifestyle. The tail seems to be partly otter, sparrow, and bear. Like including the tree kangaroo nature, they also have some lizard iguana type of mixed into it. It's many, you can see it in fun facts. And they have short legs and a lot of floof. Their wings are super fuzzy and soft, and they always have white pupils. Their size range from a size of 40 centimeter long, and if they, and that's if we don't count tail. And if we count tail, salto is about 1 meter and 40 centimeter in length. If you count 1 meter long tail, and that's basically their average. Their height is about an average on 20 to 30 centimeter tall, but it may vary. It's like between 20 and 30 centimeter. Mating season, which is springtime for these guys, when summer comes, they will have between 1 to 3 pups, 2 being the most usual and 3 being the rarest amount. Survival rate for the pups is about 70% chance of survival, and that's the salto. You can find more facts in the fun facts, like the fact that Avis saltos, they have parties! Hey, that kind of cool? Just a little random, I guess. Oh, shit.